see a failure recovery. Mm. Now, talking of recovery, you know, I've always made a joke that Susanna is basically like she's sort of a creature out of the 1950s Pathé News era, where she takes on this very schoolmasterly tune and directs the nation as to how they should be thinking and how they should behave. And this particularly manifests itself when someone utters, like Brian Blessed yesterday, did three sort of naughty words. Mm. And each time I could almost feel the school...
I didn't say anything.
..rising up. No, but I could feel it was, tensing.
It was...
I'm going to have to make further apologies...
Anglo-Saxon language.
..about this. So, any fitting? Have we got any Pathé News footage? We didn't get it. OK. Oh,
I can do it.
Only asked for an
Hello,
hour
Hello, nation. Welcome to the news.
Here.
Good morning, Britain.
Here's
it's
the reason.
Almost 7 o'clock.
Well, here's the reason we're saying this. Some footage emerged yesterday of Susanna's first ever news bulletin 20 years ago.
20 years ago this year.
On the
year.
BBC. And one word, hair. Look at this.
Good morning. A demonstration by anti-capitalist campaigners is due to start in central London this morning. It marks the culmination of 4 days of bank holiday protests. Our correspondent Nicholas Witchell is at Parliament Square. Nicholas, what's happening there at the moment?
What's fantastic? Your hair has changed.
Nick Witchell is at Parliament Square.
But Witchell, yeah. Witchell is still in Parliament Square, still talking absolute cobblers about the royal family. And nothing's changed. Look at your hair.
Oh, Playmobil hair, I call that.
Playmobil hair. It's the eyes, though. The eyes are still there. The eyes still have
it. Can we go back? Go back for a minute. It's the ambition. Go back. Go back. Look. Oh, look. It's my moment. I'm here, and I'm going nowhere for the next 20 years.
the brunette steel.
Well, except I did go somewhere in that 20 years because I'm now here.
Yeah, it's the same thing. Have you got any Pathé News footage yet?
Jenny Bond tweeted me because honestly, that jacket. I mean, it was like the news jacket and the news wig.
Yeah.
Mm. And it was like us newsreaders used to just pass it around.
Well, it's the old Star Trek. I mean, you could have wandered onto the, the Starship Enterprise in that. It's sort of Uhura look.
Jenny Bond, the former BBC Royal Correspondent, I'm sure I had a wardrobe full of similar jackets. Yeah. I expect I probably plundered your
probably
wardrobe.
Probably still
to
there.
To like, get that one, Jenny. Like... And much the same haircut. Why did we feel we had to wear a sort of uniform? Thank goodness things have become a bit more relaxed. That is absolutely right.
So true. It's like apparently the Francis Saunders sketch, isn't it? Where you go, oh, I think I'm going to get a Jan Leeming. I'll get you a Jan Leeming.
Exactly.
It's brilliant.
We've apparently got footage, I've just been told. I haven't seen any of this or know what it is, but it's footage of some other of the GMB team in their early years on TV. Oh, that's me.
Oh.
That's me on the Wimbledon News, aged, I think I'm 19 there.
Oh,
as people are saying, Roger Moore-esque. Ranveer!
Oh, look at... Oh, actually, that's from quite recently.
Yeah.
That's from...
Really?
That's from when I first came to ITV 7 years ago.
Again, look at the ambition. Look at the ambition. Look, I am coming, Britain. Look,
I'm coming for you, Britain.
I'm coming to a screen near you, is what I meant to say. Richard, moving swiftly on.
Oh! Hello!
Look at the shirt. Hey, baby!
That's a bit loose, isn't it?
We need a bit of Barry White
with
that, I think.
A bar near you.
See, there's no point in doing Hillary, because he hasn't changed. He literally has looked like this for 57,000 years.
I think I have.
Let's talk something more serious. Ozzy Osbourne.